Very good morning to all. Myself Dr. Anzar Ahmed, and in this lecture I am going to talk about Norbert's SR latch. In the previous lecture we discussed about NAND-based SR latch. So let's see what happened in Norbert's SR latch and how it works. This is the block diagram. Just see, this is the block diagram of SR or RS latch. These are the inputs. You can see these are the inputs and these are the outputs. Okay, so this is R and R and S, these are inputs, and this Q and Q bar. Okay, this is a sequential circuit, and you know what is sequential circuit, that in which the output depends on the present input as well as the pass output. So part of output is fed back to the input. And in that category, we discuss about the NAND-based SR latch. Here we will see. So this is the internal structure of NOR-based head. NOR, that is, it is the combination of NOT plus OR gate. Okay. So if we add up, that is NOT. Okay. If we add up NOT gate along with the OR gate, then it becomes NOR gate. And the part of output, that is, we have two outputs which are complementary to each other. This is Q and this is Q bar. Okay, so Q bar is feedback. Q feedback to the to this input, and we named as one gate number one and gate number two. Okay, and Q bar feedback to the input of first gate, and thus it becomes the NOR based SR latch. Now SR, what is latch? Latch is a storage device. Which store either 0 or 1. And before analyzing NOR-based SR latch, we will see in the truth table, or we will try to know the basic about the NOR gate. A NOR gate has two inputs, okay, and one output, and it is the symbol of NOR gate. This is the symbol of NOR gate. As you know already, there is no big deal in it. Okay, and this is the truth table of NOR gate. That is, NOR means OR A plus B. Okay, this is A plus B. A plus B, and if we invert it, then it becomes A plus bar. So, A plus B, 0 plus 0. Is equal to 0. If we invert it, we get 1. 0 plus 1 1. Then if we invert the value 1, then it becomes 0. 1 plus 0 1, then it becomes 0, and similarly this thing. Okay, 1 plus 1, then it is inverted by this NOT gate, and thus we get the truth table of NOR gate. To analyze SR circuit, we must remember the truth table of NOR gate. It is very important. Actually, in engineering or at many places, we use the basic. We apply the basic to get the bigger thing. Okay. So we will have a conclusion here. The output of a NOR gate is 0 if any one input is 1. So see here. That is, that is CL. The output of a NOR gate is 0 if any one input is high, C, both. These are high and the output are low. Similarly, this is 1, this is 0. So if any one input of NOR gate is 1, then output becomes 0. And we get high input only when we have both of the inputs low. So this is the basic statement about NOR gate which we will use to analyze SR latch. Okay, so this is the SR latch. I'm coming back to our discussion. And SR latch has four conditions because there are two inputs and possible combination of the input will be four. So we are having S is equal to 0, R is equal to 0, S is equal to 0, R is equal to 1, S is equal to 1, R is equal to 0, S is equal to 1 and R is equal to 1. Okay, actually SR latch kya hai? This is a set and reset latch. Set and reset latch. That is, if S is equal to 1, then output must be Q is equal to 1 high. The circuit goes set. When R is equal to 1, then Q is equal to 0. So whatever previous value of Q you have, it will be 0. So by just keeping this condition in your mind, we will go through to the analysis of NOR base truth table. Okay, so we will check all conditions of NOR gate, NOR base SR latch. Okay, so first let me start from here. That is 0, R is equal to 0 and S is equal to 0. Okay guys, so what was the statement? The output of a NOR gate is 0 if any one input is 1 and output is 1 when all inputs are 0. So here we are not going to apply here anything. I'm just considering the Q value of this is Q. Okay, Q which is coming into this, this is 1 and this is 2. So this is coming into the output of second NAND gate and this Q bar is the part of input of the first gate. Okay, so 0 plus Q bar is equal to Q bar, and then when we will invert this Q bar, then it will become Q. Okay, and similarly Q plus 0, that is this is OR gate, so then we will add up, then we will invert the value. Q plus 0 is equal to Q, then we will invert the value Q and it will become Q bar. So just check, you can consider this is N. And so what actually we are doing, we are calculating next value, that is Qn plus 1 and Qn plus 1 bar. So these are the whatever present value Q and Qn have, then we will drive next state or next value of this SR latch. What will be the next value to store? So by this one you can calculate that is when you apply 0 0, then what is the output state of the output, then we get if the previous value of Q is Q, the next state will be also Q. Similarly, If the previous state of the Qn is equal to Qn, then it will be equal to Qn bar, the same. Then the, in the output, no, there will be no change. So this is called hold condition. This will be called hold condition. Okay. So for S is equal to 0, R is equal to 0, there will be no change at the output. We will hold the condition, previous condition. Now come on second combination. S is equal to 0, that is S is equal to 0 and R is equal to 1. Okay, so let's check if there any if any statement is going to fit to calculate the value or not. The output of a NOR gate is 0 if any one input is 1. So this is the statement which we are going to apply to avoid any type of confusion. That is, this is 1. So if any input, see, this is the condition. This is the condition. See, if any if any input, this is any, if any one input is 1, that is this one, the output will be 0. So I am coming back. So this is 1, the output will be 0, Q will be 0, right? That 0 is the part of feedback into the gate number 2. So this is 0, and then 0 plus 0 is equal to inverted 1 ho jayega, then we will get the value 1. Okay. So for R is equal to 1, S is equal to 0, the value we will get, next value will be R. This is R. This is Q is equal to 0, okay, 0 and 1. Okay, because we explained this when R1 is equal to 0, that is reset condition, what we get the output 0. Whatever previous value you have, it you will get 0. So this is the reset condition. Okay. You can confirm this case by taking one example. Suppose this is Q, the previous value is Q, okay, and R is equal to 1 and S is equal to 0. Okay, so R, if any one value of NOR gate is 1, then output will be 0. Then this 0 will be the input of gate number 2. So then 0 plus 0, then it will be 1. So in that case, when you had the previous value 1, but because of this R is equal to 1, R makes the Q reset. Okay, I hope this is easy to understand. Then let's discuss about R is equal to 1 and S is equal to S is equal to 1 and R is equal to, S is equal to 1 and R is equal to 0. Okay, now what will happen? We will apply this statement. If any one input is 1, then output will be 0. So it will be 0. Okay, it will be 0. Qn will be 0. Then this 0 will be the input for the gate number 1. Then 0 plus 0 is equal to 0. 0 will be inverted. Then we will get value 1. Okay. So when S is equal to 1, R is equal to 0, then Qn, that is Qn plus 1, next value will be 1 and 0. They must be complemented to each other, because by the definition one is Q and other is the Q, Q bar. Okay, so whatever value you have, then it will set the Q. We can understand this with the example. Suppose we are taking previous value 0, okay, previous value 0, okay, and the value of R is equal to 0, which we are analyzing 0, and S is equal to 1. So see here, if any one input is 1, then output will be 0. This 0 will be the part of input of gate 1. 0 plus 0, 0, then it will be inverted, 0 will be inverted and it will become 1. So just you observe, then when the value of Q was 0, then if the value of S is equal to 1, then it will set the circuit, that is, it will give the output to 1. Similarly, last conditions S is equal to 1 and R is equal to 1. Let's see what happened. What will happen? S is equal to R is equal to 1 and S is equal to 1. Okay, so just read this definition. If any one input of NAND of NOR gate is 1, then output will be 0. So R is equal to 1, S is equal to 1. So what will get? एक आउटपुट अगर आपका NAND NOR गेट का 1 है, दूसरा कुछ भी हो, आउटपुट विल बी 0. सो व्हाट विल यू गेट? यू विल गेट 0, राइट? एंड द सेम कंडीशन यू विल गेट हियर, S इज इक्वल टू 1, सो आउटपुट विल बी 0. सो वी कैन चेक 0 एंड 0, ओके, which does not fulfill the condition of output, that is, both output or the next state can't be 0. If this is 0, then it should be 1, okay, because this is complement of Qn plus 1, right? That's why this condition is called undefined condition, invalid condition, in valid condition, okay, right? It will be invalid condition. So guys, it was all about NOR based SR latch, and just you saw how much easy this is. If you're having the basic thing, that is, you remember the basic thing, that is table of truth table of NOR gate, then that fundamental or basic things you can apply to analyze RS latch. Okay, so it was all about the NOR base SR. In these conditions, we have the memory. Here we are have the reset value, and for S is equal to 1, we have the set value, that is Q will be 1, and when we are having 1 1, then conditions become invalid, that is, and that is circuit becomes confused for in terms of output. Okay, so guys, it was all about it was all about NOR based SR latch. I hope you got it very well. Actually, there is nothing to remember. The only things, if you know that what is the working of SR latch, you can make the truth table easily. So just don't remember again and again what is this. Just try to get the logic behind the NAND based SR latch and NOR based SR latch. Why we are having NOR base and NAND base? Because in the next lecture we will discuss about the clocked SR flip flop, which is a little bit different. And that SR latch, if you are knowing these both things, that is NOR base and NAND base SR latch, if you are knowing these very well, then you can apply these SR latch to make the flip-flop easily, very easily. So very important, please try to get both of the SR latch, NOR and NAND. If you know about it, then there is nothing to understand. It's so easy. And if you know about the SR latch, then flip-flop, and becomes to understand the counters, registers, etc. It will be just the things of second. Okay. So guys, it was all about the NOR base or today lecture. In the next lecture, we will discuss some other thing, that is flip-flop. Till then, have a great time, and most important, take care.